ज्ञान थिमिरां दश्याम ज्ञानांजन सलाखया चक्षुर्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभो नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्ण That's right. So in that way, yesterday Parikshit Maharaj was asking questions to Saunaka Muni, asking questions to Suta Goswami. Arjuna was asking questions to Krishna. In that one, we have to understand the way in which to ask the questions. What about, you are doing no Tamil translation?
Tamil is very good.
So Tamil also translation is going on 107.5 megahertz. Please, sir, you can use your cell phones tuning 107.5 megahertz for Tamil simultaneous translation. But this one, we have to understand all the things. Everyone tuned to 107.5 now? Always you should have this frequency in your cell phone. 107.5 is for Tamil translation. Okay? Those who have not, they can spare with those who have. And the answers also, the person, eligible person can answer. Even if the question put in some unpleasant way, what's the problem?
No, my headset, I don't have any headsets. Headsets in some
case. Extra?
Headsets, extra. No headsets. Good.
Better you prepared and come to the class, sell with headphones. This and all, the idea of Krishna, we have to utilize that one. The person put in unpleasant way or what we can say, improper way to a person, great person, and he very nicely answered the question. Can you anyone tell who the person is answering and who the person questioned? Huh? Question kept right person in a wrong way. The answer given by the right person to the wrong person in a
better
manner. Who are these two? Prabhupada, to whom? There are so many. No, that's not the specific one. Specific one is Prakasananda Saraswati is putting the questions to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu very nicely answering. So if you want to get the right solution, we have to put the person to a very right person. Choosing the person is also very, very important. So in this class also, I don't know how much I am getting the mercy of Krishna to give you the solutions, but I will try our best to get the solution from Krishna. By the mercy of Krishna, we can do anything and everything. So now, if anyone has any question, then I can try to answer. Any Mataji side, any question? It is better to have the competition between Matajis and Prabhujis. Who is asking more questions? Mataji's first preference. No Mataji's? Yes. I'm sorry, I cannot hear. Hey, you have extra 88.5? You should bring that also. 88.5.
We have to switch it after. When we are not using, we have to switch it.
Let us see. Yeah, yeah. To Sai devotees. Your problem is how to preach Krishna consciousness to the devotees of Sai Baba. Okay? I told also, you were telling Sai Baba was empowered. And you cannot forget that you are also empowered to put this question also. Krishna is empowering each and every one. Because we are all children of Krishna. So Krishna is helping. Okay? Many people, they got attached to Sai Baba. Many everybody are telling her. Recently Sai Baba name has come, but before that one, no one knows that one. When I was child, actually telling, only few people on Thursdays, they worship Sai Baba. They put this bondi. Bondi and they distribute that bondi to everyone. So it is very nice, the tendency of the people is, if someone is helping someone, they get attached to that person. Whether they do not know whether the help is really needed one or wanted one. They do not know actually. Because all the people, children and all, they are getting bundi, sweet, no? So they also say, Sai Baba, Sai Baba, some jones. Like that one, even the brahmanas, they are also following Sai Baba. If Sai Baba can be able to give them material boons, they get attached. So, Krishna consciousness is entirely different than the devotion to Sai Baba. This first the preacher should understand. Sai Baba, devotees are after material benefits. Material benefits is not permanent. That is not touching the soul. It is only for material body. When we are forced to give up our material body, everything is lost. Everything is lost. We cannot have that one because that and all not ours. You understand? To acquire them, we must have done so many mistakes. Offenses. Isn't it? Blunders. Impious activities. To get the material bones. We don't deserve. That's why Krishna is not sanctioned. But still we are insisting. And Sai Baba is providing. So during this process we are doing so many things. The reactions of that only ours. Not the products. What we are using are ours. Yesterday also I was telling this one. Only using that equipments, instruments, the reactions or actions what we get, that only ours. So that only we are carrying even for our next birth. So the instruments what are we used, that are all coming with us. So we are supposed to make them understand that what is material boon. The material boon is meant for what? And what is spiritual boon? That is meant for what? The distinction between body and food.
You should be able to explain to them. Yes. You should be able to explain to them.
Then they can easily understand, they can come back. We can ask even the devotees, you are attached to Sai Baba, and you can very well ask Sai Baba himself what is necessary for us. What we are supposed to do after the death, what, where we are going, what is our destiny. Now we are keep asking you something and you are providing that one, but we never ask you what is required for us. You have not given us what is really wanted by us. Needed that, yes, you never give us. So please help me. You understand? In this way we have to explain them. Don't tell that you stop worshipping Sai Baba. That we cannot say. They should understand and they themselves should stop it. Like that one for ISKCON, many people, those who were attached to Ganesha, Lord Shiva, Dhamma, they all get that worship and they come to Krishna and understood that by worshipping Krishna, we are all worshipping
all the devotees. By individually to worship this demigods, we cannot please Krishna. By pleasing Krishna, all the demigods were pleased. So we are not carrying the instruments or whatever may be the appliances we possess, that we are not carrying, that are not ours, that is due to Krishna's. But using them, what the results we get, that only we are carrying. I will give some example. Suppose we have some feast for thousand people, we are arranging some feast. But we don't have the vessels. We get the vessels on hire. Isn't it? On hire. Each one we can get for 100 rupees, 150 rupees, 50, different bigger vessels. We bring them, we use them, we prepare the feast. Then afterwards,
we cannot claim that this is all ours. We have to return them back. But what all we are cooking, that is all ours. Is right? Suppose you are going to an internet center, you don't have internet facility at home. You are going there, they are providing you internet, the desktop, chair, table, even drinking water, fan, air condition facilities all. You can go there and you can work. You cannot claim all these instruments are yours, but what all the work you are doing, that you can take in your pen drive, you can come out. You cannot claim all these things, my internet is mine, and this desktop is mine. You cannot say, you cannot claim. But what all the action, reaction you are doing, that we can collect in our pen drive and bring out. The same way, in this material world, we are getting this facility, that facility, two bangles, so many bank balances, that and all not ours, that and all belong to Krishna. But using them, what are the things we absorbed, we accumulated, that only we can carry. So for anyone in this world, we can easily convince them and bring them back to Krishna. You understand? What are the things they are doing, that and all only from material pool, material facility, which are not permanent. The permanent thing is only for working to soul, that is with only Krishna. This way, we have to convince them. We cannot say that one, what they are doing is wrong. If you say that one, you are losing your chance of convincing them Krishna conscious way. You cannot say any negative statements. We have to always give positive statements. Then we can win their hearts. Otherwise we cannot. We cannot think that we are the best, they are the worst. This mentality is not at all beneficial for us to convince others. Always we should have compassion. Oh, they don't understand this one, and I don't have that much idea, that much knowledge to convince them. We should depend upon the mercy of Krishna and have compassion over them, pity over them. Pray Krishna and help them. But we cannot criticize them. We cannot minimize them. If you do that well, we are not helping Krishna actually. So this way, any preacher can easily convince anyone who got attachment to anyone else than Krishna. You got the answer? First of all, we should become strong in Krishna consciousness, thoroughly. Then only we can convince them. Otherwise it's not. Anyone for that. That's very, very strong, because that one is helped by Mayadeva. Ours is, we are using Krishna's mercy. That is difference between Maya and Krishna. Krishna cannot sever his mercy easily. But Maya, even if you don't ask her, mercy of Maya, she is readily pouring mercy on us. Even if you beg Krishna, he will not shower his mercy. So we have to be very, very careful. If you lose Krishna, then Maya is already attacked us. Maya is already existing. So we have to be careful. If you forget Krishna, Maya is already there. So this way we have to preach and convince anyone very nicely. Okay? Now Prabhuji, have any questions? Let's have one Prabhuji side, huh? One by one will come. Who is going to win? You take the score.
Yeah.
If anyone is not asking the last, huh?
Oh, yeah.
That's all. Prabhuji is one by one, yeah.
Raja?
Achha, okay.
So his question was, Hiranyaksha pushed the Somi to capture Somasha. What happened to the Somasha?
This is statement, have you read anywhere?
What?
The Hiranyaksha pushed the earth in the water?
Yeah.
You read it?
Yeah.
Can you get me the reference? Anyone accept the statement? Hiranyaksha pushed the earth planet into water.
Not in the water, but in Neptune.
Anyone read this one in Bhagavatam?
I read it.
Hiranyaksha, he put that in water.
Not in water, Neptune that plant. He has put it in the Neptune plant.
Hiranyaksha does not have that much power to push the earth to ocean. First point we should understand. Then he is actually preventing the earth coming out from water. It is not by the Hiranyaksha that was put in water. Please understand. That time, there was no that much population, what we need not bother for that one. Hiranyaksha is what yuga it was?
Satya Yuga.
Satya Yuga. Very first one. There and now the population is very, very less. When Brahma was thinking, Brahma was asked, create the universe, he first got Sanatana Kumaras, Chatur Kumaras, and he asked, Kumaras, you have to bigger children now, we need the populations. But the Kumaras told, no, father, we cannot get into this family affairs and all. We cannot beget children, we cannot have the benefit for this and all. We don't do all these things, it is not beyond our scope. So we don't want. So Brahma got even wild and he cursed them. What was the curse? You will never grow. You remain children only. Best of your children. Even spiritually, that is the Buddha, the curse, both are the same. This may be the curse for Brahma, this is the boon for Chatukumaras. Because of his angry, who came out?
Rudra.
His name is Shiva, Rudra. Raudra. He was very angry, Raudra. Because of that one, Shiva came. Then Brahma asked, oh my dear Rudra, now you can fulfill my desire. You have to have children. He told, yes father, I will have children. He started begetting children, but he could not control the children. They are disturbing Lord Shiva. He always meditated. No child was allowing him to meditate. One is getting on the head, one is getting on the back, one is like this. He told that, my dear father, I cannot put this children. No, I am stopping. You understand? So this is not something he was, the very first one. So it was not that much the population were there, that when the earth was, you know that pralayam comes. Pralayam comes, means all the waters and all, they come together and everything is immersed in water. That time Hiranyaksha is not allowing the earth to come out afterwards the pralaya. He is pushing the earth down on it. that no one got that one not to do, the earth pushed inside the water. You understand? That's creation by God. There are so many planets rotating on their orbits very nicely, very finely. So Hiranyaksha doesn't have that much power to put the floating earth inside the water. Water is in earth, earth is in water. Can anyone tell?
Water
they are mentioning there. Hiranyaksha is pushing in the water. Which water that
one?
You mean to say there is some formation? Some new formation has come?
It was before the creation. It was only water.
How can you say? I don't understand. Kasa ocean is common. In that Kasa ocean only we have universes. The universe outside is Kasa ocean. Now we are talking within the universe. That is Kasa ocean is outside the shell of the universe. So we are talking inside the universe. Inside the universe, as he is telling, the Garbhodaka is there. Garbhodaka Sai Vishnu down. Earth is in the middle. Hiranyaksha cannot push that one from the middle planetary system to the lower planetary system. That much power he doesn't have. But when the pralaya comes, everything is inundated. Inundated water, completely immersed in water. That time it comes out now. The Hiranyaksha is not allowing the earth to come out. He's pushing that one. You understand? So that time only this Varaha incarnation and he fought with him. He killed him. He brought that one outside the water. So Krishna is there, we have to understand that one. Krishna always does good. Paritranaya sadhunam, vinasaya chadushkrutam. Those who are miscreants, for them it may be distressful. But those who are the pious, for them this is pleasure thing. Good pastime. So there is no that population shortage or damage or this, that and all. So, you know, Palam is going to come. Even tsunami has come. Partial things and all that happens every now and then. But at the end of Brahma's night, the total pralaya is coming. Completely devastating. That no one can avoid. The other things are all partial, hither, thither, 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 you know, that happens. That's all. It's all the complete one. But he did not allow the earth to come out. He was preventing. So that one he was showing his power in that way. Yes? That is the creation. Aamam. Avangaludaiya reaction. Anga irukkira jeevangalukku adhe reaction. Avanga poogam pannikitta paavakarma kadigam anga vaadu. Adhanale adhu thadarkka mudiyadhu. Yaaraadu paavam pannaangalo anga paavam palithathai anubhavichitaanga. Okay. Yes, Mataji, you were asking something. Achamula, acham. Parambura. Okay.
My question is,
Acharya last year, he was Brahmana. Yes. Got spoiled, polluted. In the spiritual, okay, I understand your question. In the spiritual journey, we have different stages. Topmost stage is love of God. Next, below that one is bhava stage. Understand? Even if we reach bhava stage, there are chances for us to fall down. Nista, so many levels are there. First is Sraddha, then Bhajana Kriya, Anatta Nivritti, so many stages. And then we are reaching Bhava, finally we are going to love of God. Even if we reach the Bhava stage, there are chances for us to fall down. Falling down means we are getting affected by the influence of Maya. You understand? We have that affinity of influence of Maya. Why so much you are telling, you are adding so much, that should be within the brackets, that's not the clarity. You want to, everything is very, very correct. That is there, I'm telling you. You just take one bottle of water. Your bottle is very tight. There is no holes. But even there is slight crack in that bottle. What happens? Even the crack is there. The water is coming out. Isn't it? So like that one, if we are not completely 100% Krishna conscious, Maya's influence is there. The bottle is not 100% guaranteed for leakage. You have leakage. Understand? Unless or otherwise you are not 100% Krishna conscious, there is chance for you to get influenced by Maya. But 100% Krishna consciousness is the love of God. Even slightly less than that is bhava stage. Even in that bhava stage we fall down. The bhava stage, anyone, particularly Chaitanya Mahaprabhu tells, even Lord Chaitanya's ladies, they cannot sing in public. In fact of Prabhuji's. She may be singing very nicely harmonium, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. That bhava, even the force in Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to come and embrace that singer. Isn't it? That bhava made us to forget ourselves and we do not know what we are doing. In that bhava also we get this influence of Maya. So unless or otherwise we are not 100% Krishna conscious, unless or otherwise we don't get love of Krishna, we cannot. See, he is singing very, very nicely. He cannot get attached to the singer. He should get attached to what Hare Krishna, what he is singing. That song, the meaning of the song. You understand? In that song, we have to see Krishna. We have to get attached with our song, but not the person who is singing that one. Then it is love of God. You understand? Vatthavat Ajamula Bharata. Bharata understood everything. He left everything. He came to forest.
He thought that I have nothing, I am completely detached. But Maya never left her free. Huh? Early morning, he was about to do his meditation. That time when lion roaring, that sound heard by a deer, the deer was pregnant, full pregnant. Out of fear, there was the canal. The deer just leaped from this end to that end, out of fear. So the baby delivered and fell in the water. Exactly that time he opened and saw. He heard the sound. The vision is like this one. The mother, deer is jumping over and the baby falling in the water. How Krishna Maya is acting. Under the direction of Krishna, the Maya is acting. Maya is so perfect. He thought that, the baby deer, no one is there to take care. He forgot. He left everything, knowing that I am going to be taken care of by Krishna. And after seeing the dear baby, he thought, who is going to take care of? How much the Maya can trick us. He got attached the baby deer. He lost all. So, even the Baba, he's very nice singing, he's very attractive. In that one, we have to see the hidden end of Krishna. That is very, very important. He's very nice listening, he's very nice this, that, and all. That's not important. In that one, we have to see the Krishna. Rest and all the transformed energy of Krishna. The real energy of Krishna we have to see. Then only that is the love of God. That is the prema. Otherwise this is only bhava. Even the bhava also influenced by Maya. So we have to come to 100%. That's why even in my test and all, for wrong answer I am giving negative marks. I want everyone. Now maximum everyone is getting 95%. I am not giving them 100%. No, I don't think so. There is chance for anyone to get 100%. My questions are like that one. In my questions, you are getting the answers, no? My answers?
All the answers,
That complete answers you are getting, no? We are not bothered. Now itself, before attempting the exam, we can go for many, many trials and all. In that one, we can fail also, no problem. But when we are going to face the real test, then we should be very, very thorough. No one in this world can make the first paper like me what I did, isn't it? No, even in ISKCON, no one has prepared papers like this one. This thing, Krishna said, mercy upon me. That's why I got this paper. Minus means minus. And grace marks also we are giving. Even Krishna is also, is very much pleased sometimes. He gives the grace marks. So we have to be very, very careful. That's why the, what is the term? The sum of all the scriptures, the essence of the scriptures is always remember Krishna. They are not stopping with the statement. Also they are adding, do not forget Krishna. Always remember means do not forget. But still we insist that positive side, remember Krishna. Negative side, do not forget Krishna. It is transcendental. It is not either positive or negative. It is more than, beyond that one. So that's the answer for your question. You got that answer? Yes?
So what are, there are two questions sent by Meena Mataji. I have my questions. Realization, it is two things. One is Brahman realization and then Bhagavan realization. Bhagavan.
Who told like this one?
So three stages of Brahman, Paramahansa, but Paramatma, there is no Paramatma in the spiritual world, only Brahman effulgence is there, and then Bhagavan is there. Paramatma where in the spiritual
Paramatma world? Paramatma is available only in this material world.
That is my question. So, in spiritual world only two things are there.
Spiritual world also, that Brahman is not spread everywhere, like here in this material world. In material world, the Brahman is spread, evaded in all the places. But in spiritual world, forget them. In spiritual world, this Brahman is concentrated to one particular point. It's not spread over everywhere. You understand? That and all concentrated in one particular place, that is called
Brahma Jyoti.
You understand? That's not spread out throughout, that's not necessary. That is self-effulgent, spiritual world.
So who is Paramatma Yogi, he will go into that Brahman
Jyoti.
He will go there only, he will not.
There only he has to come back.
Oh, yes. That's all.
So what are the other questions?
Other question I have. What are the tips to get attached to Krishna more? What are the ways to get attached to Krishna more?
How you get to Krishna's more?
We are doing
if chanting. If you get detached from material world, material acts, how you can?
By chanting, by sadhana.
Trying to please Krishna in each and every act. Yat karosi, yat tasnasi, yat juhosi, dadasi. Yat tapasasi kaunteya, tat kuriswa, madarpana. You understand? So this is very, very important. Manmana, Bhagavad Bhakto, Madhyaji, Mam Namaskuru. This is all very, very important. When you give up your false ego, all these purusharthas, what are the purusharthas?
Kama.
Purusharthas.
Dharma.
Dharma, Artha, Kama, Moksha. Isn't it? This way we can get attached to Krishna. If very first step is lovingly chanting His holiness, particularly Mahamantra. Then following the four regulative principles, then taking prasadam after offering that one to Krishna, then only we should honor that one. This way we can easily get attached to Krishna. Avoid the association of Maya. If you become pure devotee, then what will the thing happen? Someone is coming and knocking the door. Who is that?
Maya.
Vaikuntha Vasi.
Maya.
Maya itself, Maya Devi coming and knocking the door and tells with folded hands, how can I serve you? That is the love of Krishna. If you get 100%, then Maya will come, knock your door and tell with folded hands, how can I serve you? So Maya is also very much interested in serving the devotees. All the time she is attacking all non-devotees. She gets bored up also. Someone asks the bodhisattva, one time, isn't it? Even that. If Maya comes across a true devotee, she wants to render service to such a devotee also. So 100% Krishna consciousness is very, very rare. Durlabha. It's not that much easy. Become, even Maya Devi comes to serve you. Even Krishna Himself coming to serve you, no? Krishna becomes charity. Then what's about Maya? Maya, Krishna, now you can get a power, I will serve. I will serve your servant. Why you are serving? Let me serve.
So this is the thing, in fact. So I had to, how to become 100%? If you thoroughly understand Krishna, thoroughly can see Krishna in each and everything, you will become 100% Krishna conscious. If you are selfless, if you are self-motivated, it is not possible. You cannot see Krishna. You are seeing Krishna everywhere means you are selfless. You have no self-motivation. You understand? Try to become selfless. Isn't it? Then only we can see Krishna. Then only even Maya comes to serve you. If Maya coming to serve means, what are the Lakshmis? Lakshmis are ready or not? Hey Maya, you don't come here, he is my devotee. Let me serve. There is the competition between Krishna, Maya and Lakshmis. Not only single Lakshmis, there are thousands of Lakshmis. Such a person wants to have something. There is no problem for fundraising. You understand the point? So 100% means very, very fortunate. That only we are supposed to be like that one. Prabhupada also told, if even one of my followers becomes such a pure devotee, my mission is all perfect, all successful. Yes? Does that answer for your question? Yes?
Two questions by Veena Mataji. One question. So the parents, they only have a daughter. So in that old age, the Vedas say, scriptures say, parents should not stay with the son, only son, not with the daughter. So these parents only have daughter. Is it okay? What else they can do? They have to stay with the daughter. That is okay or not? That is it a sin? Or can they?
Stay? Who are the parents or what? That the parents are devotees or non-devotees? She mentioned like that one?
No, but
so these are imaginary persons. You understand? We are thinking ourselves, if I'm going, some tiger comes, what can I do? I can say, Krishna, Krishna, Krishna. I'm trying to see the Krishna. Why you are imagining like this? You understand the first point? We are talking about whether you have child or not. Whatever may be your material position, that is not the impediment for Krishna consciousness. If you have Krishna consciousness, if you are Krishna conscious, whether you have one son or one daughter, there is no difference. Krishna is always with you. Whether your daughter is with you or your son is with you, is not the person for a devotee. Devotee is always feeling that
Krishna
is with me. He is taking care of me. Yogakshema Vamyaha. You understand? This time even Vedas telling they have to be with son. No son is ready to keep their parents also. What the Vedas going to tell that one? The joke you know, no? The one son, he become 35 or something. He wants to take his father to the old age home. His wife and all not favorable for him. So he is forcing the father, I'm taking you to there. He arranged everything, he spoke even to the old age home and he brought the father to the old age home. Then both came inside. Then the father went to that person who is in charge for that and he's speaking very nicely to him. Very closely, very nicely. The son got some suspicion. How come my son, my father knows him so closely speaking to him? I only came here, I only spoke to him that I'm going to bring my father here. And he got the doubt. How my father is very nicely frequent. Freely he is speaking to the person, then you ask the person, you know my father? Then the person told, you do not know so many things. 35 years back, your father, this person only, took you from this ashram. Your orphanage is the time. He took you, he brought up you this one, and now you are bringing such a person to put in this one. He become ashamed. This is Kali Yuga. They have no respect for parents. Shastra, the Vedic Shastra never told like that. Even if a father is a drunkard, you have to give due respects. Each and everyone must give up the due respects. No Vedic Shastra is telling like that to all. So if you have only daughter, you cannot stay with your daughter, you become devotee, pure devotee, 100% love of God. Then Krishna is taking care. You understand? That's why we are telling, don't remain non-devotee. Try to become devotee. This is our urge. Everyone should become devotee. Then everyone will get Krishna's shelter. Anatha. They are telling you anatha. Anatha means?
Natha.
Natha means one who maintainer. I don't have maintainer. Don't tell like that. Krishna is maintaining everyone. That's why he is called Harijana. Hari means Krishna. Krishna Jana. No one should feel anatha. If he is feeling anatha, he is non-devotee. He feels Krishna, then he is pure devotee. So that's why we are spending proper sacrifices life to give this love of God to others. Not make money and put in our bank balances. Many people they claim, they got this many buildings, this many bungalows, this many cars, this property. That is not the thing going to come with us. If you become love of God, of Krishna, if you get the love of God, love of God, Krishna, then we are going along with Krishna. That is the opulence we should acquire. Not this material opulences. That's the question. Answers for your question?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes, another question. How your devotee wife has to handle
devotees?
Wife is Krishnakanti, yes. How she has to handle unclean unclean shabby husband.
Only that much she felt. She understood her husband only that much. If anyone thinks someone is shabby, he is Krishna conscious. Anyone who feels my husband is, what all things he stole?
Unclean.
Unclean.
Shabby. Husband.
Then the wife is not Krishna conscious at all. You understand? We cannot have the mentality of donkey. There was one story. The people in the village, they made the idol of Krishna. They are taking that idol to the market in city to sell out. They have the cart. In that cart is driven by donkey. So the donkey is pulling the cart. On the cart, this idol of Krishna was kept, and the cart is moving. All are coming. All are coming and going now. They are Krishna. They are going to Krishna. And the donkey thinks, you see, they are going to me. They are going to me. I am so great. Isn't it? See, all these people, they understood me. I am so great, they are going down to me. this foolish donkey, he doesn't know they are
worshipping Krishna.
Bowing down to Krishna. Like this, this one and all. Anyone who thinks the husband is dirty, shabby, then she cannot be a devotee. That's wrong assumption. She has to chant very nicely. Her vision is not pure. She doesn't have the mercy of Krishna. You understand? We have in scriptures even the paralysis husband.
Paralysis.
He wanted to go to brothel house. The wife takes him to brothel house also. She's the wife. Nowadays, we cannot find the real wife in Kali Yuga. That's not possible. That's why I told you that one. They say that one. The stri means.
Expand.
No, stri means expand. The name. Dharma Patni. Dharma Patni. White means Dharma Patni. Should be Dharma Patni. Why it is called? There is no Dharma Pati. Please understand the distinction between these two. There is Dharma Patni, but no Dharma Pati. Dharma Patni means Pati has all possibilities to come out from Dharma. He easily deviates from Dharma. The Pati has all the chances to deviate from Dharma. Dharma Patni means he should be like that one. She should help him so that he never deviates from Dharma. The nature is like that one. The men, they easily get spoiled. They deviate from Dharma. Sadhi nahi karne se barbaad ho jayega. If one boy is not getting married, he will get spoiled. See? That's why we are getting him
married.
So, the boys means they have all the chances to get spoiled. That's why we are marrying him. The wife should act in such a way that the husband should not deviate from Dharma. That's why this is called Dharma Patani. That's the duty of the wife. Why is he called the female body? She is such a sinful person earlier, that's why she got a lady's body. Now Krishna is compensating. At least if you do service to such a person. The male body means pious. Okay. Those who did pious activities, they get the male body. Female body means impious activities. So to compensate that one. If you render service to him, you make him perfect, then you are going back home back to God. This privilege for ladies. You are in such a worst condition. Now also I am giving you this privilege. You do this one, you are going back home back to God. That's right. So for that one, in any condition, your husband is like that one, shabby or
unclean.
You should make him smart, good look, and clean. Then you can say that you are devotee. If you call your husband unclean, shabby, you are not, you are demoness. This is the thing we should understand. We cannot think that when I am devotee. You understand? Otherwise, he is going to lose even the human body next life. If she thinks that I am so better, my husband is not good. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. It is not going to fetch her any good thing. She cannot claim herself as the devotee. Devotee means one who devoted everything to Krishna. Krishna only provided such a devotee to you. That's sanctioned by Krishna. That's why such a husband has come. If you are telling your husband is such a fellow, you are scolding Krishna. How you can say that you are devoted to Krishna then? The simple thing, without the sanction of Krishna, nothing is taking place. Even such a savvy and unclean husband is only got you by Krishna. Then you are denying him. You are denying Krishna's arrangement. How can you claim that you are the servant of Krishna? Logically speaking. You understand? The knowledge we cannot use our own. The knowledge should be given by Guru or Krishna. Brahmanda?
Ramite Kona Bhagyaman.
Ramite Kona
Bhagyaman
Jiva. Guru, Krishna, Prasadepaya, Bhakti Lata Bija. Those who get the Bhakti Lata Bija, the creeper of the devotional service, they can only claim, at least I got this Bhakti Lata Bija, I am trying to become devotee of Krishna. Otherwise they cannot claim, I am devotee of Krishna. You got the point? I don't know, even what's up and all. The name, what they are telling? They are paying their obeisances to themselves. So and so, Prabhu, Ji. So please try to change your names in WhatsApp. You cannot write yourself as Prabhu Ji or Mata Ji. For ladies, mean Dasi. Devi Dasi, normally they call. Some people, they don't call themselves. They don't write Devidasi, like what is name? Then also we never get the mercy of Krishna. Prabhuji's also they cannot use Prabhuji. They have to write only
Dasa.
Dasa. Please don't change your names at all. If at all you are wrongly mention your names as Prabhuji's, that's not correct. Self-respect should not be there in Krishna consciousness. We should ready to give even the persons, those who are irrespectful to us. How we can give respect to our own? If you are giving respect to our own, we cannot respect Krishna. You understand? No one should claim that I am so great, my husband is shabby, unclean, foolish. These words and all are fit for a woman. Then we may lose even the woman body. So we have to be a Krishna conscious person, devotees of Krishna means they should have some responsibilities. Then only they can claim that I devoted myself. Devotee means I devoted. We have to devote. But we are expecting so many things. I should have very nice, beautiful, hero-like husband. That's not the expectation of a woman. God so kindly gave you chance, given you ugly, shabby, untidy husband. And telling, my dear daughter, I have given you such a husband. You are my devotee. Just clean him, beautify him, make him. Then she can tell, I am very nice, Krishna has given me very nice chance for me to prove myself that I am devoted to Krishna. I possess the mercy of Krishna. By using my mercy, I am going to change my husband. then we can glorify, we can worship also. You understand? So we cannot encourage as questions, that's not good. They never understood and they are claiming themselves as devotees. You understand? Yes. Anything else?
No.
Yes.
Yesterday one person came to my house.
Yes.
And 2 years back he used to come one or two times to our classes.
Okay.
He said he come with some problems. He worked with some company. The company owner took his phone, cycle and ATM card.
Why?
Because he tried to get his, he worked with that company.
Okay.
The same job he is doing, coming out of the company and doing that same job. So that he don't want that next owner.
How come you do the same thing without the concern of the company?
The company is doing the cleaning services.
Okay.
House cleaning.
Okay. Maintenance of the homes.
This person come out of the company.
Started.
On his own.
On his own.
And that person.
How he got his belongings?
One time he just left that same company.
So when he is coming out, he should have taken that out, no? When he is coming out from that company, he should have taken all those his belongings to him?
No. When he was purchasing something near to that company, that person saw him and take care of all the things.
How he can give, take away means what? How he can give it?
By forcibly.
Oh, force of putting it.
So he can lodge a complaint.
Police complaint.
That's what he is telling. He is a very big person.
Why he took this one?
Because he is the business competition, because of business competition.
So he should complain this one. Because he is foolish. He thinks that I was working for this company, I can become big man than this owner. Isn't it? And he doesn't have any shelter. He wants to prove himself that he is a great hero. That's a very great offense. One who gave you the way and you want to pierce his eyes. Isn't it? Absolutely wrong. He is completely materialist. He never has any idea of God. Krishna is seeing everything. Isn't it? He is doing something wrong. At least if he has the center of Krishna, then it is nice. He doesn't have that. He has to suffer. He has to at least know he is surrendered to Krishna. Even now he is not surrendering to Krishna, then that's all his life is wasted. He wasted his life. Next life he is not going to get even human body. That is guaranteed. A man means he should understand his responsibilities. One who doesn't understand his responsibilities as though he is in human form, he is an animal. He cannot be human body. Is not a human being. Human being means he should understand his responsibilities. His prescribed duty. Sreyan Swadharma Vigunaha. His prescribed duty is what? To purify himself, whatever may be the profession he is doing. Krishna is telling, you are Arjuna, you are the Kshatriya, you do your duty. Your prescribed duty is to fight and think of me. That is your prescribed duty. He wants to cheat his own owner. He wants to do. He doesn't have even the shelter. With what reference he was doing that one? Was he reading Bhagavad Gita? Nothing. What is use of he coming to two or three classes? What he learned from that one? So he learned nothing. That's why he has to suffer. But Krishna is so great. even if you kill women, cow, brahmana, kshay, anyone, if you utterly surrender to me, I will eradicate all sinful reactions of your actions. Do not fear. So only one thing is surrender, utter surrender. Then Krishna.
Him, I just see the person. The same thing he said. I only given the job to him. I only given the food to him.
Now you spoil your name also.
And
you spoil your name also. You recommended him to that company.
No, not that one.
Oh.
I just went there to see that person.
Achha.
What he said, the owner said, I only gave the job. He was in city, he was crying to get a job. So I given the job. I given the food every day. But he just go out and he
tried to that's wrong, no?
That's why I'm angry. I took all this.
Correct. The persons are like serpent. Even if you feed a serpent milk, nectarian milk, what it is going to produce?
Poison.
Poison. Is it? The characteristic of serpent is poisonous only. But what is, which can bring the change in this world? Which can bring the change?
Holy names.
Huh?
Holy names.
Huh?
Holy names.
Which can bring the change? Huh? Devotional service. The third chapter, second canto. Completely devotional service change in the heart. Nothing else is going to bring change in the heart. To bring the change in the heart, we have to render some devotional service to Krishna. Huh? So such a mentality in people, they will produce only piles. The Gandhari was got married to Dhritarashtra. Gandhari is coming from Gandhar to Hastinapur. Along with her,
her
brother Sakuri also came. Sakuri also brought up here. And what he was producing?
Paisa.
Only paisa. You understand? We have to engage them in devotional service, then getting them some job. First is not providing job, getting them
service.
In chanting. Service. The very first step is that one. Then only the rest will come automatically, one by one. So we have to be very, very careful.
Sangati is very important.
Which one?
Sangati.
Association.
Sangha.
In that association only we can learn something. But some people, they want to give association. They don't take association. Those who got the false ego, they don't take association. They want to give. They want to show. So such people also there. Association means better take association of others, saintly persons. Association is not any association. Association of devotees. Normally say saintly persons. Otherwise it's very difficult. We cannot help them, providing them the jobs and all. The very first step is we have to convince them to chant. Then only the rest comes. Otherwise it's very, very difficult. We cannot help anyone. Right?
This incident, can we say this dispute? Can we consider as a dispute and we cannot just...
There is no dispute for a Vaishnava, there is no dispute.
So in this case, can we see as a dispute and should not go and speak with the Gopi, or it is wrong?
2 persons, owner and worker. So is it a dispute or not, he is asking. Owner has problem with the worker.
Owner has no dispute. Now this boy is regarded as a dispute. Owner has nothing wrong. He has no wrong. Huh? The boy has the, he has to go and ask for forgiveness. Then you may consider.
We have to go there. Is it okay?
No, you cannot go now. You should only insist him to chant Hare Krishna. This thing I am telling, a Vaishnava helping means not getting some job is not helping. A Vaishnava means spiritually you should help him. Just insist him to chant Hare Krishna. Then only you are a Vaishnava. Unless you are also materialist. Huh? The very first thing is, you have to make them to chant or you have to give them prasadam. These two things, nothing else. Even if you give some book, read means he will not read. Huh? He'll keep that one aside. Huh? Just we should insist him to chant. It's not chanting, give some prasadam, at least it has some influence. Huh? So anything else? Okay? Next Sunday, as usual there. Okay? Okay, Hare Krishna, thank you.